Hello and welcome to ESPNcricinfo Dailies. I'm Nikhil Shetty with the top cricket news this Tuesday. First up, Neil Wagner is set to return to the New Zealand's bowling attack for the second test. The India women's team win their second successive match in the T20 World Cup. And Josh Butler says he still has the drive to succeed in test cricket. First up, Neil Wagner is almost certain to be back in New Zealand's bowling attack for the second test against India, which begins in Christchurch on Saturday. Wagner missed the first test in Wellington on paternity leave, but he will return to the squad on Wednesday, replacing Matt Henry. Debutant Kyle Jameson, who came in for Wagner in Wellington and shone with both ball and bat, has left New Zealand in a bit of dilemma over who to play and who to leave out in Christchurch, but coach Gary Stead indicated Wagner would feature. Hagley Oval is a venue that has traditionally favoured seam bowlers, so there is a chance New Zealand might go in with both Wagner and Jameson in a four-man pace attack alongside the new ball pair of Trent Bolt and Tim Southee. India put on another superb performance while defending a total, using smart bowling combinations to suffocate Bangladesh's chase after squandering a brilliant start with the bat. Player of the match Shefali Verma, 17 ball 39, anchored an innings that fell apart in the middle, but a late cameo from Veda Krishnamurthy helped India put up 142. Bangladesh had little in the way of partnerships as they set about this chase, and they were stifled by Poonam Yadav's 3 for 18 and Shikha Pandey's 2 for 14 to fall short by 18 runs. India are currently top of their group with 2 wins in 2 games. England batsman Josh Butler has admitted that he cannot continue to be picked on potential alone at Test level after being retained in England's squad for next month's tour of Sri Lanka, despite an off-colour showing during the recent Test series in South Africa. Butler's form has been a concern after he scored just 115 runs in 7 innings with a highest score of 29. Butler, however, insisted he still has a drive to succeed in Test cricket, which he describes as the best form of the game, and says that despite a test record that now comprises a solitary century in 73 innings at an average of 31.74, he retains the massive self-belief required to become a world-class player across all three formats.